The work of the Press Club Elections Totus 2016 is underway. The seventh session has become no less interesting. Its topic was elections, political modernization, experts' opinions. Well-known scientists in the field of political science and international relations shared their opinion about the course of the elections in Uzbekistan, as well as democratization development as a whole. Among them, there were foreign experts and domestic scholars.
To date, we cannot say that there is a single model of democracy. In each country, it acquires its own peculiarity.
I traveled the world a lot. I worked in roughly 100 countries, and I lived in six of them. I've seen all sorts of democracy, even systems that were called democracy and that were not democracy, systems that were, I would say, openly not democracy. When I think about universality, there's not such a thing. As soon as you travel the world, you understand that there are many things that come into the picture and that makes a universal model quite irrealistic. I would even say somehow imperialist. So, what do we need to have a democracy? Well, first of all, we need Democrats. How do we produce Democrats? We need education. We need to develop a culture of democracy. I think in this regard, if you now talk about Uzbekistan, you're on the right path.
Talking about democracy nowadays, I think it's a very delicate matter. Democracy is shaking these days. As was mentioned before by our friend from Great Britain, many European countries took them between 100 and 600 years to establish real democratic procedures. And, well, we in Greece, for example, we discovered democracy, but it took us about 700 years to destroy it. Democracy is a very delicate flower. We need to take care of it. So in your country, here in Uzbekistan, for example, you have only about 25 years of independence and just about the same time of trying to establish real democratic procedures. We have been doing a great job, I believe.
Thus, foreign experts praise the process of democracy in our country. They noted that in such a short period of independent development, 25 years, the country has done much in the way of building a civil society. There is not really an easy task. Special attention was paid to the high level of political culture of citizens.
Our country views this event as decisive for our future. I think that in this regard, this tradition is not subsiding. On the contrary, this activity will surely be on the rise, especially if we consider our youth. I think Mr. Mohammed Sheikh has already said that 60% of our population is made up of those under 25 years old. Today, they are the most active part of our political electorate.
The diaspora, the Uzbek diaspora in England, are being allowed to vote. In fact, they will vote on Sunday. And I asked somebody who is from this country, I said, why are you waiting? Why are you voting? The answer was, I care about my country. And I get that impression that people here care about the country.
Lord Mohammed Altaf also praised the achievements of the first president of the Republic of Uzbekistan, Islam Karimov.
Now, I mentioned that I feel that President Karimov has done a very, very good job. One of the things he has done is having peace and stability. And that is very, very important. I had a meeting earlier on with certain business people, and I'm a businessman. And I was saying that as a businessman, I am always looking for peace and stability if I'm going to invest in your country. I believe that part of that reason is confidence in the president.
During the session, experts also pointed out that in the era of profound political reforms, the Uzbek people have been able to preserve their national identity, strengthen national statehood, which served as the basis for peace and stability in the country.
One of the greatest achievements of Uzbekistan during the years of independence has become the strength of Uzbek national identity. Without having this, many nations suffer and face some challenges. Every day we can see that the world is becoming more complex, turbulent, The competence is growing, and during this time it is important to have the basis, the roots of statehood and national identity.
The experts also emphasized the role of the Mahalla as a factor of democratization of the society. For example, Guy Olivier Faure praised the role of Mahalla Institute in Uzbekistan, which, incidentally, is unique in its kind. In an interview to our channel, he shared his opinion.
What you have is mostly sociological elements to bring into the picture. First of all, you had a wonderful ancient tradition, Mahalla. And I believe myself that it helps you to catch up so fast with democracy. I tell you why. The way I understood myself, Mahalla, was that in the small group, people have consideration for others, respect, more than that, care. And finally, they're concerned by everyone and their problems. And I think that if you expand slowly on from the small group to the larger one and to the broader society, then you address the whole population of Uzbekistan.
Talking about the positive change taking place in our country, it should be noted that for foreign experts it became clear that elections were yet another proof of the development of democracy and modernization in the country.
I mean, the organization of the electoral process is still perfect, you know, the whole environment, how people prepare the meetings and how all these things are settled and pushed forward. And then the city looks very modern, you know, there's a new hotel I've seen, very modern architecture, and yeah, the city looks clean like last time. I think it's really a lot of signs for dynamic growth and development.